Hello, everybody, Wooster Naz family and friends. Pastor Nathan here, genuinely thankful for another opportunity to connect with you. In these days and in this season, what has God given us? He has given us a spirit of power, love, and wisdom. What more do we need to navigate and traverse these challenging and often troubling times? His power, love, and wisdom are available and are enough to provide all the answers we need and seek. These are sourced by the Holy Spirit through His powerful presence and by God's precious word in our lives. All who have said yes to a love relationship with Jesus, we must access it and apply it and live it daily. Be encouraged. Challenge. Love is truly a decision about how we choose to treat one another, especially in the middle of differences that seek to divide. This will never be powered by human will alone, but by the will of God and our agreement with His will, powered by the Holy Spirit who lives in us. God's word instructs us to always be loving God and people. John 13:34-35. So now, I am giving you a new commandment. Love each other just as I have loved you. You should love each other. Your love for one another will prove to the world that you are my disciples. Our love for God and people is only a response to His great love. 1 John 4:19, my paraphrase. He loved us first, and that's why we can love. God's love constantly flowing to and from our hearts is not only a profession, but a possession, a daily practice. This remains our motivating source for all times. I know of nothing that hinders and weakens the message of Jesus more than a lack of love. Genuine love attracts people to Jesus. This is the only love that has the power to change the world, one person and heart at a time. Here's the bottom line. When we love Jesus, we must love each other, and there's no end to it. This is to be our distinguishing characteristic from the world. They'll say, wow, how they keep loving each other through everything. God's heart is full of compassion and love, grace and mercy. He is looking for people who are full of the same things, like Jesus. We are never more like Jesus than when we love God and people unconditionally. Only the work of the Holy Spirit on our hearts can make this a reality. Enough said. Come in this house. This is one of my all-time favorite lines from the Andy Griffith Show. As I remember it, only Andy spoke these words, and loudly, to guests who knocked on their front and back doors. I love it. A friend of ours had a sign made for us to hang over our front door at home. Come in this house. We have been gathering on site for worship since May 24th. Last Sunday, we had 545 come in this house, along with many more on our live stream. We had nice crowds for both 9:15 and 11:15 worship. There is definitely more room to spread out at the 11:15, and our 208C venue is still available during both time slots. I want to extend a warm and sincere invitation to all of you who can and will, as your health allows. Come in this house. Haven't you missed it? There's something so special about being together, and that will never change. FaceTime and Zoom are great, but being together in person is best. I love this new song that gives me spiritual goosebumps, The Father's House by Corey Asbury. Lay your burdens down here in the Father's house. Check your shame at the door. It ain't welcome anymore. You're in the Father's house. Prodigals come home. The helpless find hope. Love is on the move when the Father's in the room. Prison doors fling wide. The dead come to life. Love is on the move when the Father's in the room. Miracles take place, the cynical find faith, and love is breaking through when the Father's in the room. Jericho walls are quaking, strongholds now are shaking. Love is breaking through when the Father's in the room. Lay your burdens down here in the Father's house. Check your shame at the door. It ain't welcome anymore. You're in the Father's house. Come in His house. Moving forward, we are constantly meeting, praying, and planning for the days ahead. Our staff and lay leaders are listening to and learning from best practices from many sources and from each other. Our dialogue has been heavy at times, but outstanding. We're growing and getting better. We're making plans to add youth, NAS Kids and Little Sprouts at appropriate times and in the best ways we can. This will most likely be a gradual fade-in, especially for our preschool children. More information will be coming your way soon. Another big dialogue topic is how to improve our care team connections as we continue to move forward. No church should take better care of people than we do. We're not the only or the best of anything, but strongly desire to be creatively and solidly on the top shelf with the very best. Blessing. When I was growing up in my immediate and extended family, after wonderful visits and before we departed for our homes, my parents would most often initiate prayer together. These prayers were primarily brief, thankfully, and were filled with praise and thanksgiving to God. Commonly, the last thing that was said before getting in our vehicles and heading home was, "Blessings on you." We were taught to pray, believe, and speak God's very best blessing and favor over those that our hearts held so dear. This is a very distinct and sweet memory of my distant past. So now, in the exact words of one of my few famous best friends that I never met, Billy Graham, until the same time next week, may the Lord bless you real good. Remember, you're invited. Come in this house.